In this video, I'm going to show you how to recreate some of the tools inside Batman's utility belt. Before I begin, if you enjoy this type of content, make sure to like and subscribe. The first is the iconic Batarang, a custom-made shuriken that you can recreate if you have the right tools and material. The video from the King of Random is a good tutorial on turning a table saw blade into batarangs. However, shurikens were originally made to be disposable, as such used cheap material. You can mimic this with something like a Grip-Rite fastener tin disc, a thin but sharp piece of metal. It's easily bendable and could be unusable after a couple of uses, but they're also cheap. You can modify them with scissors to make them more into the shuriken shape, but you can also use them as is, which is probably more efficient. Now, if you want the more knife-like attributes of the Batarang, you could also purchase throwing knives for a relatively reasonable price on Amazon. Now, the use of both of these items require a certain level of skill to be consistent, so you need a lot of practice. Next are his smoke pellets, which Batman uses to disappear. You can recreate this with no work at all using the blue/pink smoke from gender reveal devices that you can buy on Amazon, though I am unsure if it's going to be enough smoke to temporarily blind the enemy to help you get away. In this case, you can also create a concoction with sugar and potassium nitrate, with the latter found in items like tree stump remover, and this is the exact brand used in the Modern Rogue video. You heat both materials until it caramelizes, then pack them into a medium like a cardboard tube, and then light it on fire, which can then cause a lot of smoke to be produced. Third is the lockpicks to help Batman enter restricted areas such as a crime scene to collect evidence. It's easily bought on Amazon, and you can get something like this, which is a lockpick set disguised as a keycard. There is a tension wrench and a couple of different picks to choose from. The only issue might be that its peculiar shape of being flat and wide, it may not fit all locks. And it could limit your opportunities as there's only a couple of picks to choose from. Nonetheless, if you do buy this one or something else, you do have to practice to become an expert. The fourth is a Swiss Army knife, which Batman can use for a multitude of miscellaneous tasks, such as unscrewing, screwing, cutting, wire stripping, etc. You're only limited by the specific type you buy and your creativity/knowledge of the multi-tool. This particular one is the Fieldmaster, which at the time was on sale, but I believe it's around $50. And it comes with two blades, a saw, a screwdriver, a wire stripper, and more. The most expensive one is the Swiss Champ, which has so many different tools that it's almost ridiculous. The multi-tool would be a replacement for the miniaturized Bat Tool Kit. The fifth is a first aid kit, used for injuries for Batman, Robin, Batgirl, or the citizens that he saves. There is a variety of choices on Amazon, including ones that are filled to the brim with items you may never use, though it's nice to have the option. I'd also recommend adding in over-the-counter painkillers like ibuprofen, Tylenol, as not all may come with it, or it could be a topical version, which may not be enough. The key point is that once you buy it, make sure to go through the kit and understand what each item does and what it's for, so if a situation occurs, you are better prepped. Sixth is an acetylene torch, most likely an oxyacetylene torch, as it burns hotter with the oxygen tank than without. Batman can use it to cut through ferrous metals, which are metals containing iron, though not cast iron, as it would require more time and the cuts would be uneven and rough. It also isn't ideal to cut through metals like aluminum or stainless steel, as it does not oxidize, so the cuts will not be clean, but it should melt at that high heat. But beyond what the torch can and can't do, the main issue is that it's expensive, costing around $300 or more. you're better off with a plasma lighter for the aesthetic look. But if you do want to cut through metals, then you want thermite. Which is number 6. Thermite is a mixture of iron oxide powder and aluminum powder, both of which is finely grounded. You need to have the proper portions of each and also a magnesium strip, as the powder has a high flash point. When ignited, it causes a reaction from the aluminum being oxidized from the iron oxide. You can buy both items from Amazon for a relatively reasonable price. Finally is an EMP, or electromagnetic pulse, which is a short burst of electromagnetic energy, which can be either natural, from geomagnetic disturbance, or from an intentional attack, both of which can cause severe damages to electronics. The specific one I'm referring to, like shown in WikiHow or in YouTube tutorials, will not cause massive damage, but most likely affect small electronics, specifically ones that aren't shielded. Now this may seem useless, but it could cause a chain reaction if you use it correctly, as if you damage a small piece of electronics in a larger mechanism. So dependent on the hypothetical mechanism that you would attack, the effects could be devastating. Thank you all for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe, and you can support this channel if you wish by hitting the join button.